When the Picts come after you, they never stop. Etain, like the wolf, has learned to hunt from birth. Now she hunts Romans. Now, we are the prey.
Here's your chance to watch an exclusive advanced screening of a full-length feature film before it hits theaters. Magnolia Pictures presents Centurion.
It's not your sort of typical swords and sandals, caper. It's more sort of like a, something like Apocalypto or The Fugitive even, where, you've got a handful of Romans just running for their lives, trying to get back to the border.
Somebody told me about the legend of the Ninth Legion, or this Roman legion that marched into the mists of Scotland and vanished without a trace. I started doing my research, and I want to find out what might have actually happened to them if they did disappear.
I'm Quintus Dias, second in command, Inchtooth Hill Frontier Garrison.
Well, sorry we couldn't get here sooner.
Are you the relief column?
Not quite.
I'm Titus Flavius Virilis, commander of the Ninth Legion. Come here looking for a fight.
And you'll get one.
So the Ninth Legion goes in pursuit of the Picts and goes deep into sort of into Scotland. Basically, they just fall directly straight into a trap.
Picts were savages that lived in Scotland. They had very rough life and they were very resistant.
The Picts are probably the birth of guerrilla warfare. The numbers were lower, they didn't have the same artillery or numbers. So basically it was that idea of hit and run. Using the natural elements like mist, fog, just using surprise as the advantage.
Quintus is Centurion. He's the Centurion of the title. Because he's kind of smarter than the average Roman, he's learned the Pict language. He wants to understand the enemy that he's fighting.
Here I find a horse.
My story came into being that way of telling it through the point of view of a member of the Roman army who survived the initial attack and has to fight his way back home through hostile enemy territory, back to the Roman lines.
I have a message for your general. Now point me in his direction before I have you flogged.
Well, then I suggest you get down off that horse and give me your message before I have you flogged!
They were the top legion of the time. General Virilis, who existed, he was actually he's a historical figure. They're called up to do what none of the other legions can do. And then the myth goes that they went into Scotland and disappeared. And Neil speculates what happened to them.
Dominic brings a real kind of brash energy to the role. Yeah, I'm sure he was possessed by the spirit of Oliver Reed.
He's sort of the best, the ideal general, the ideal leader. He's just adored by his men and adores his men, treats everyone really well and drinks with them and fights with them and just a nutcase. Couldn't be more fun to play. I just make long speeches and fight much bigger men than me and win, because they're stuntmen.
We all that's left?
We were outsmarted.
The general's still alive.
You sure?
I saw them take him away in chains.
Which way?
North.
Then we follow north.
Olga plays a fascinating character. She has one thing on her mind, and that's killing Romans, and she does it very well.
A demon stalks us day and night. They call her Etain.
If Etain is hunting you, you might as well be dead already.
Etain has no tongue. Her whole family was killed when she was a child, and that's why she is personally very angry with Romans, because it's something personal. It's not only that she's defending the land, but she wants to get back at them. All she's about is revenge and fighting and being resistant, and I think it's more interesting because she couldn't talk. I really looked at her as an animal.
Michael Fassbender, Dominic West, and Olga Kurylenko. Magnolia Pictures presents Centurion. Centurion premieres in theaters Friday, August 27th. Can't wait? Now there are two ways you can watch it in your own home before it hits theaters. Order it now on demand or pay-per-view, or watch it on HDNet Movies Wednesday, August 25th. To get HDNet Movies, call your provider and order today.